Hello, I'm here with my first edition of Q&A with Dirks and Dabbles. My first question is from Amanda, who has a couple of kids, and so her question to me was about how she can display her children's artwork in her own home, but that isn't so kid crazy and more fits in with the adult interiors that she has going on. So. I do have a couple of ideas. There's a lot of stuff online that you can find, so I've pulled a few ideas from there as well to give a few options. So the first is really pretty simple. You probably think about it already, but it's just to frame your child's artwork and hang it on the wall, which I think there's a few different ways you can go with this. The first is more simple, is to just get a bunch of frames that are exactly the same, really plain, like maybe some just black frames, put the artwork in there and then hang it in a really straight line or in maybe a box 3x3, so that it's really simple. Your eye goes to the artwork, it doesn't get overwhelmed, and has kind of a clean finish to it. But then there's another way you can go kind of the opposite, is to go maybe to like Goodwill or a thrift store and get some really ornate, wild frames and put the artwork in there. Maybe you can spray paint them all the same color, maybe you can have them different colors, and then when you're putting them on the wall, have it in more of a fluid arrangement instead of really straight lines. just to kind of give it the interest that the artwork, I'm sure, is really fun and not straight lines, so it could work really well in that kind of arrangement. The other idea that I found online, which I really liked, was to actually get a fairly long curtain rod, a metal one that looks really nice, and then actually you can get those clips that you put on that have clips on them, the rings that have clips on them, and they're made to hang a curtain with, but instead of doing that, of course, you would hang the artwork with it. And I like this idea because you can interchange the artwork fairly frequently whenever you want to put new stuff. You can put different sizes up, which can be nice, and then it also gives a really clean professional look to it, as opposed to maybe like hanging twine with clothespins or something like that. So I think it could work really well. And then the last idea that I had isn't really for displaying the artwork on the walls, but a way to have it available and to keep forever is to actually take all of the artwork and take photographs of them, and then upload those photographs onto a web service like Snapfish or any place that you can upload your photos, and then most of those will have an option that you can actually make a book out of your out of the photos, and it can be usually a hardback or softback. And I think it would be a really great way to maybe every year you can take the artwork that your child made that year. You can say, this is Bobby, you know, age 5 and his creations, and you can put titles on it or little explanations of what the child has described is in the picture, and then even giving it as a gift to your child, I think, is a really good idea, maybe every Christmas or every birthday, just to show them, you know, like this is I think they'd be really proud, this is a real book, it's got my own artwork in it. They can show it to people that come over, maybe grandma, grandpa, or their friends, and just really foster that creative importance in your child. So there's a few ways that you can really bring the artwork into your home in a special way. And that's a really good question. Thank you for asking, Amanda. And so if there's any other questions that you have, please submit them in the box below. I have a few more already in waiting, but I'm going to need more after that. So I can't wait to hear your questions. Until next time, bye-bye.